Throughout all history, man has established an almost perfect record of ignoring the inevitable. Man recognizes the fact that the sun will rise tomorrow, not because God promised, but because it always has in the past. When God promised that the world would be flooded by water, the promise was ignored by all mankind, except in one godly family. Thus, man was destroyed except this one family. The coming of the Messiah as a baby was foretold in detail for many generations, yet only a few accepted him as the Son of God. It seems that only after these events happen that man recognizes that God's promises are never broken. The Bible speaks plainly of another great event that will soon take place. Christ promised to come and to receive his own to himself. As a thief in the night, in the twinkling of an eye, we shall rise to meet him in the air. But again, this promise is being ignored by many. What you are about to hear has not yet happened, at least not at the time this was recorded. But as sure as the sun rises in the east, it will come to pass.
Hey there! Are you moving and grooving? Are you singing and swinging? This is yours truly, the Swing Man. Got a cut now for five, but don't go away. We'll be right back to sock it to you with more of that moving and grooving music from the Swinging Show. We'll be telling you of some out-of-sight happenings coming up this Saturday night, so hang tight for 5 minutes of news coming up right now.
The war in the Middle East is over, and today the peace treaty is being signed by all the powers of the world, bringing a peace to the world for the first time. The One World Police Force is going into effect, which will put an end to wars in every nation. For the first time in history of mankind, there is peace and safety for everyone alike. Three teenagers were charged today with illegal possession of drugs and breaking and entering. Officials say the youths were arrested in a raid last night. Their names are being withheld because they're all juveniles. Cost of living has gone up 2.1%. This is an increase of 1% over last month. And the weatherman says we're in for another rainstorm. It's due to strike this area sometime tonight. Here's an item just in on the local scene. A 3-year-old girl is reported missing from 103 North Beard Street. The child was wearing a gold plaid dress and has long blonde hair. When the mother was asked how long she had been missing, she said that just a few minutes ago they'd been walking down the sidewalk and the little girl suddenly vanished.
Shake it loose and let it fall. Don't miss the scene, babies. Take it out 5 miles on a south side freeway. It's a weekend of sound and happenings. The gates open Saturday night at 9, and it's a solid 17 big hours of the In Sound with yours truly, the Swinging Man. Be there for the biggest weekend of sound in your lifetime. Advance tickets available all over the place. It's a weekend of happenings starting Saturday night at 9, and we'll be looking for you, baby, and bring your beast. Be there.
We interrupt our program for a report from our traffic helicopter.
This is your traffic helicopter, and we are directly above the South Side Freeway, where the strangest tie-ups we have ever seen has cars blocked in both the north and southbound lanes. When we first approached the freeway, we thought there had been one accident. But I can tell you that these tie-ups are not the results of one, two, or even three wrecks. All along the 3-mile stretch of highway from the city limits all the way to the Beltway, there are cars off the road to the left and the right in the north and southbound lanes. Traffic on the Beltway is almost exactly the same. No apparent connection between the accidents. There is just an unending string of single and multi-car wrecks. We have covered more than 6 miles of highway, and there is no end in sight to the pileups. There is absolutely no way for the cars to move in either direction. do not attempt to drive your car or to come anywhere on the south side. We will give you further information as we cover the different areas of the city.
We'll get back to our traffic helicopter as soon as we can. Now we take you directly to the Metropolitan Airport for this news report.
Everything has suddenly gone crazy here. There were two flights due several minutes ago. One of the stewardesses on flight 621 radioed in just now. She's in hysterics, says that several passengers, some adults, and all the children have simply vanished. When she went up front to tell the captain, both he and the co-pilot are gone. The plane's on automatic pilot, but there's no one to bring it down. We still haven't heard. Wait, here's a report from flight 463 now. What? I can't believe it. One of the stewardesses and several passengers have disappeared from the plane. A choir of 60 children returning from a singing tour have all vanished. Here, inside the air terminal, bedlam has broken loose. People have just disappeared. One of the men here in the tower has vanished. We can't find him anywhere. The parents and bus driver waiting for the choir members have all vanished. There's not a child left in the terminal. What's going on? People are going crazy. We need help.
This is News Central. We're interrupting all previously scheduled broadcasting to bring you all the factual information as to what is taking place as we receive it. A few minutes ago, our telephone lines were suddenly jammed by what we thought to be a mass hoax. We can now tell you that it's not a hoax. Something has happened. Our helicopter and mobile units have confirmed that something has happened. Traffic in the entire county is one gigantic traffic tie-up, and it's at a standstill. Don't attempt to go anywhere in your car. We're continually receiving calls from hysterical people claiming that people have suddenly vanished. How many of the reports we're receiving are a result of panic? Of course, we just don't know, and we urge you not to panic. This can only add to the confusion. Here in News Central, we have direct lines to all law enforcement offices in the county, 7 mobile units throughout the area. Our teletypes and radios link us to the rest of the states and nations. You're urged to please stay off the telephone so emergency calls can get through. Do not call this station or the police with anything but factual reports. Don't ask us for information. We'll broadcast all verified reports as we receive them. Our lines are now open for factual reports. Please give your information, then clear the line. This is News Central. Go ahead.
I'm the manager of the South Park Shopping Mall, and I can tell you that people have vanished all over the place. Everything is in a turmoil here. Every child in the place has disappeared, and there's not one to be seen. Many adults have vanished, and one lady was standing at the checkout counter. Just as the clerk reached out to take her money, she vanished. The clerk and ladies who were standing there are all being treated for hysteria. Several stores report clerks having disappeared, some while waiting on customers. People are going crazy. Outside in the parking lot, traffic is jammed. People have vanished right out of their cars. People are running everywhere screaming for their children and companions who have simply vanished. We need help. There's shoplifters who are taking advantage of this awful situation. They're stealing everything they want with no one to stop them. Help us, please help us. I can't get through to the police. We need help. Please help.
Hold it, here's another urgent bulletin.
I have an emergency announcement. This is Lieutenant Jones, Central Police Department, and we request that all off-duty law enforcement officers report to their division commanders immediately. I repeat, we have an emergency situation and request that all off-duty law enforcement personnel report to their division commanders immediately. We have one other request. We request that the citizens, please do not call the police. We are having a problem with phone calls, and we have no information on the emergency at this time. I repeat, we ask that you do not call the police department unless you have an extreme emergency. As soon as we receive any information on what's happening, we will notify the broadcasting company immediately.
Mobile Unit 3. Hello, this is Mobile Unit 3. This is Mobile Unit...
All right, go ahead. You're on.
Unit 3. I'm out here at Hillside Cemetery covering the funeral. It's the strangest thing I've ever seen. You won't believe this, but the hearse, the family car, and minister have already arrived at the gravesite, and in the process of carrying the casket from the hearse, the pallbearers apparently dropped it. The lid flew open, and there was nobody. Most of the pallbearers seem to have just disappeared. There's hardly anyone here now. The minister and most of the family are gone. The other cars haven't arrived yet, and looking down the hill to the road, there seems to have been some sort of large accident. There's a huge traffic jam blocking the cemetery entrance. I just can't understand what's happening. I can see graves ripped open all around me. Oh, it looks as if they have exploded from the inside. That's all I can say. I just don't understand. That's all I can say. I don't understand what's going on.
We have a report from the Northside General Hospital.
This is the nurse's station in the surgical wing of General Hospital. We have a very strange situation here. An elderly lady was undergoing major surgery. In the operating room were two doctors, an anesthesiologist, an intern, three nurses, and the operation had been underway about 35 minutes when all at once she vanished, right off the operating table. Those in the operating room, including the doctors, are now being treated for shock. It's also reported that several of our patients have disappeared. Many too ill just to walk away. I've never witnessed such an occurrence. I just don't know what to think.
Our Mobile Unit 5 has just contacted us from downtown. Go ahead, Unit 5.
I've been involved in an accident. I'm sitting in a mobile unit in the corner of Broadway and First Street. I was stopped here at a red light when a car veered across the intersection and struck the side of the mobile unit. I got out to see if anyone was hurt. I know it's hard to believe, but there wasn't even a driver in that car. The whole downtown area is just a mass of confusion. The traffic is jammed. People are running. Others are trying desperately to get their cars out. I've seen some trying to drive on the sidewalks, running people down as they get in the way. Others breaking glass and looting. We need help down in this area fast. You just can't imagine the uproar. The few police that are here can't possibly take care of all this. I don't know what awful thing could have happened to upset the whole town like this.
Well, let's take a little time here in News Central for a recap of the information we now have. For the past 40 minutes, we've received the most baffling reports ever heard at the station. People from all walks of life are reported missing. Many say the people have actually vanished. Traffic across the entire country, we understand, is at a standstill. Hospitals are overflowing with accident victims, many people suffering from shock. Ambulances are unable to get through the traffic jams. Helicopters are being dispatched throughout the country for emergency transportation. If you have need for urgent transportation, please call us. In the downtown area. Well, we finally contacted the law enforcement agency at the state capitol, and we now take you directly to the state capitol for this report. I'm sorry, but the report isn't ready. We'll bring it to you as soon as possible. It's 2 hours since we began receiving calls at our switchboard. It sounded so strange and unbelievable that we felt it was just some weird hoax by pranksters. However, it took only a few minutes for validated reports to make it clear that all the reports we'd received could not reveal just how serious and widespread the condition was that existed. A state emergency was declared in our country an hour and a half ago. Martial law has been declared for the entire state, and we now know martial law has been declared in our neighboring states as well. And it's inconceivable that even with the complex communication systems that exist across the nation and around the world, whatever's happened is of such magnitude that we still have only a few concise reports from our nation's capital or from any other major city. Well, now we bring you a report direct from the Northside General Hospital.
I'm the administrator of the Northside General Hospital. The situation here has gotten completely out of hand. Emergencies are coming in faster than we can possibly take care of them. We have no more room. Some of our doctors and nurses have just disappeared, making us very short-handed. So from this moment on, this hospital is closed. Do not, I repeat, do not come here to this hospital for medical help. We cannot take care of you. We are setting up emergency stations in schools, auditoriums, any place we can, as soon as possible. Do not call here seeking your children. There is not a child in this hospital. Please stay off the telephone so that we may use them for emergencies. I repeat, please stay off the telephones and do not come here for treatment. All doctors and nurses, anyone with medical knowledge, please report here to this hospital. We need all the help we can get. Please help us.
We've received word that under martial law, it's forbidden for anyone to attempt to move a vehicle anywhere in the state. Military helicopters will be dispatched in an attempt to get injured persons to school buildings, which are serving as medical backup centers. Well, we're ready now with a report from the state capitol.
The following is now official law for all people in this state. Under emergency regulations and martial law, the following mandates are hereby effective. All persons are ordered to remain in their homes. It's forbidden for anyone to attempt to move a vehicle for any reason. Persons violating these laws or any persons found looting or taking part in a riot will be severely dealt with. More rules will be imposed as an appraisal of the emergency shows them to be necessary.
Be enforced. The past 4 hours has been filled with the most stunning events ever recorded in the history of mankind. People from all walks of life seem to have just vanished from the face of the earth. Law enforcement agencies and military forces are not able to maintain even a semblance of law and order. Riots have broken out. People are not safe, even in their own homes. Worldwide communications are severely crippled. All national and international news services have combined their information for a worldwide summary. To bring you this report, we now take you directly to the nation's capital.
These earth-shaking events that are taking place where you are not localized. From every corner of the globe, reports are similar. The disappearance of children and people from all walks of life just cannot be explained. From the ancient burial grounds to the modern cemeteries, hardly a grave on earth exists where some graves are not torn open and bodies gone. No one knows what's happened. No one knows what the outcome will be. In every major city, every nation on earth, criminal acts that defy belief are taking place and appear to increase as moments go by. Planes are missing. Some are known to have crashed. Movements of troops of the World Police Force to employ martial law is a virtual impossibility. All we can say is that whatever has happened, we have experienced what in the light of our knowledge must be terminated supernatural.
This is Bob Smith. I'd like to speak to my wife if she's still there at the church.
Well, she's not here. In fact, people that came for choir practice and prayer meeting are gone. They've all just disappeared. I came down here after my kids, and they're gone. Oh, there's not even a child here. These people are saying that the rapture has taken place and Jesus has come and taken them away. I'm scared to death. I'm afraid it really has happened. Oh, I wish I'd given my heart to God. I really planned to. I just kept putting it off, and now it's too late.
I'm coming
right
down.
I'm so glad my kids are Christian. But I thought I had plenty of time. Oh, I wish I hadn't waited.
Well, I'm coming right down to the church.
Sir, it won't do you any good to come down here. You couldn't even get in the church. Everyone here are crying and screaming and praying. there in hysterics. And I don't know what to do. Oh, God, it's too late. It's too late.
To sing amazing grace. destination heaven, home of life eternal, knowing not of sin and strife, a place of joy supernal, in a land of endless day, there to meet my King. Destination heaven, evermore to praise his name.
Anybody?
of glory as the world is asleep and rest. Everyone shall bow before him to confess. Some have turned their back upon him, and they say they will not heed. Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they say. Oh, how sad to face a just when unprepared to meet thy God. They'll regret it on that great and fearful. Won't it be sad to see your children as they fall down on their knees? Lord, my mother never taught me how to pray. Why, my daddy never told me that there was a burning hill. That is why I am so sad and unprepared. When they see the signs in heaven and the moon turn into blood, and the people gathered round the great white throne, and the Lord will judge his people by the deeds that they have done. They'll be parted friends and loved ones one by one. Some will begin to their goodness, we have paid our honest debts. We have gone to church and tried to pay our dues. But the Lord will greatly answer, 'tis the one who does my will. So depart from me, I say, I must refuse.
Come to him today.
step inside those pearly gates. City that looks o'er the valley of
This is Leon Harris of the Singing Harris family introducing the testimony of a dear friend, Reverend D.B. Caves, pastor First Assembly of God Church in Prineville, Oregon. On June the 5th, 1972, the church was in a badly needed program of constructing a new sanctuary and educational facilities. Reverend Caves had taken a pickup load of trash to the county dump. In the process of pushing the trash off the truck, he fell approximately 18 feet into a pit which had been on fire all night. Striking the rocks at the bottom of the pit, he crushed his heel, breaking the ankle, crushing the third vertebrae in his back, and cracking his spine. The fall was so hard that it broke loose the fatty tissues in the lungs, also receiving first, second, third degree burns from the hot rocks. He was taken to the local hospital and then transferred to the St. Charles Hospital in Bend. They did not think that he would live. He was in intensive care 5 days. The second day, the doctor told Mrs. Caves that he had gone into heart failure and his blood pressure was dropping. Knowing that he was dying, she called the church for the people to pray. Reverend Hootman came to the hospital and joined hands with the family and asked God to spare his life, that he had a work to complete for him. Reverend Caves did miraculously recover from that accident. But the testimony of how he went to heaven will stir your soul. Here is his testimony as he gave it in his church on Sunday morning, September the 17th, 1972.
My life is not my own. This morning, I have a life, but it don't belong to me. The Lord sent me back to this earth with my life, that I might be a witness unto men and women. In 1 Corinthians 2 and 9, but as it is written, eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither hath it entered into the heart of man, the things which God hath prepared for him that love him. On June the 5th, of 1972, I left the house that morning, telling my wife I would be back in a few moments. I never came back. Another man came and he told her that I was injured. And I was taken to the hospital, then transferred from the local hospital to St. Charles Hospital in Bend. And there I was for 22 days. I wasn't supposed to live. I'm not supposed to be alive this morning. It's only the mercy of God that I am. For 5 days I was in intensive care. The last thing I remember was my chest had gone into convulsions. During this time, I had an experience. I don't know how long it was because time didn't mean anything to me. I was transported by the Spirit of God into the heavenly realm. Being transported to the heavenly realm, it was something that, an experience that I'll never forget. Friend, if you're a saved Christian this morning, never fear death. There's no gravity to hold you when you're a child of God. You leave this world and slip out without any gravitation to hold you down. It's a wonderful experience to be with the Lord. When I got to heaven, Jesus met me. And as he met me, he reached out and took hold of my left hand. As he took hold of my left hand, we started to turn around. And as I turned around, there was a host of angels standing there. And those angels had their wings folded. And as they were standing there in awe, I remember I said to the Lord, as another angel came up and he stood. He closed his wings and he stood there. I said to the Lord, why do they stand in such reverence? He said, you're one of the redeemed. They can't sing redemption's story, but you can. Friend, it don't make any difference which one of us go to heaven. If we're redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, you won't get there otherwise. But if you're redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, the angels stand in awe. In heaven, there's love. In heaven, there's no dirt. There wasn't a speck of dirt on the streets there. Or should I say the vast domain of heaven. I stood in awe and I looked at heaven. As I looked out across it in the vastness of it, there wasn't no supports as we have in buildings. It's like the sky that is held above us. And it was beautiful. No clouds. No blackness. Nothing was dark in heaven. As I stood there, the Lord again, he took me by the hand. And they led me over. And I saw a crystal stream flowing. And folks, I'm here this morning to tell you, I never saw anything so beautiful in all of my life. I stood there and I looked at that crystal stream, the water flowing. And I waited for a twig to come floating down, but it never happened. See, I was thinking in the carnal, but I was in the celestial place. I was in the realms of heaven. And as the water began to flow down, I stood there. I didn't see one speck of dirt. I didn't see any sand on the bottom. Nothing was dirty. I want to go back. And then I turned and I looked to see where the water was flowing. And as the water was flowing, it went under a wall, but it wasn't a wall. It wasn't a wall. It was the most beautiful light. It was a wall of light. There was not one dark color in the light. It was a beautiful color that there has been no paint company has ever been able to match. There is no paint here in this earth that would match the beauty of the wall, and it was rolling. It was rolling in colors. And it would turn as the master would turn himself, the colors would change in the most beautiful golden colors, the sunlight colors. And as they would change. And I stood there. You asked me how long I stood there in heaven. We don't measure time. There's no night. And as the water was flowing underneath of this beautiful wall of light, I heard singing. The most beautiful singing. I heard it. I said to the Lord, can I go in? He said, no. Then I remember so well that I said, who is in there? He said, that is the resting place of the saints, awaiting the resurrection morning. Those that are redeemed, those that I've called home, Those are the ones that are there waiting. The resurrection morning. Beautiful singing. Anyone think you're asleep when you're in heaven, you got another thing coming. You got another thing coming. And as they were singing, I turned. I said to the Lord, can I go in? He said, no, you can't go the second time. You cannot go in. I says, is my dad here? He said, yes, he's here. Then those that I had funerals for, I began to ask if they were there. Brother Ernie Copeland, he said, he's here. Friends, this is an experience I'll never forget, and I hope you never forget it. I said, is Sister Neoma there? He said, yes, she's there. Is Sister Peggy there? Passed away with cancer in early 30s. He said, she's here. Then I turned and I was asking about Grandma and Grandpa Hill. He said, they're there. I turned and I said, is Sister Ernest there? He said, she's there. Friend, a host of other names I named off. And finally the Lord turned to me and he said, they're all of you. Every redeemed saint of God. I said, how about the children? He said, they're here. I turned again and I said to the Lord, can I go in? He said, no. I stood and I said, why? You know, we're kind of prone to say why. He said, because I hear the prayers of the saints. This is where you come in. I hear the prayers of the saints that are coming up. He said, I have to honor those prayers. You have to go back. You have to go back. He took me by the hand again. And I turned to go. And as I did, I turned toward the river. And I saw it flowing as we walked along out from under the throne. And friend, I want to tell you something this morning. It was flowing out from under the throne. And I saw the throne, but I didn't see God. The angels were standing with their backs to me. And I know what Isaiah meant in the 6th chapter. In the year that King Uzziah died, and he went into the temple, those angels had 6 wings, and with twain they did cover his face. And as they stood there, their back was to me. They didn't have to fold their wings that time. They weren't looking at. And as I looked, I saw the most beautiful color coming out from the throne. And the Lord said, there's no man seen God or lived at any time. And friends, I didn't see God, but I saw where the throne was. A beautiful place. And a holy place. My brother-in-law says, after you tell me this, he said, you almost make us wish we hadn't prayed so hard. Pray to come back. But the thing I would ask, as I stood there and I beheld the glory of the Lord. When I came to the place of the Lord, he said, I want you to go back. He said, I want you to tell the people that I left all of this. I came down to a sin-cursed world, to a world that was steeped in sin and is steeped in sin. Go back and tell them I left it all that they might come and inherit the kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven. That they might have access to the heaven's glories. And friend, this morning, Jesus came all the way from heaven, a long, long way. And he came down to this earth that you and I might have life, and we might have it more abundantly. Then, when I awoke in the hospital room again, hands was working in my lungs, cool hands, the hands of the Master was working in my lungs. And there as he worked, took time for my lungs to get back to strength, but they were worked. They came in every 4 hours, shoved what they called a bird in my mouth. It was a little air deal that they put in my mouth. And I was to breathe that thing every 4 hours for 15 minutes. They said, we're trying to get you to cough up that which is in your lungs. I don't know how I could cough anything up what the Lord fixed. There wasn't anything there to cough up. The Master fixed it. There. And friend, this morning, I want to say this one thing. I don't want to miss the rapture at any cost. I don't want to miss going to heaven to be with the Lord. You say, well, folks are sleeping there. No, they're not. They're not sleeping in hell either. They're very much alive in both places. Very much alive. The rich man, he was in torment and he knew it. But are you this morning ready for the rapture to take place? Jesus is coming very soon. Not going to church just once in a while will do it. Not going every Sunday will do it. But it takes a communion with the Lord. It takes a communion with the Lord. It takes you and I to be redeemed by the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Friend, this morning, are you ready for Jesus to come? I want to go back. I want to go back. I might say this in passing. We've looked at houses, and I told my wife she had to pick anything out that was all right with me, because I said, everything's dirty to me down here on this earth. After being in heaven, I'm not contented just to sit here. I want to go back. How many of you this morning want to go? Let me see your hands. Raise your hands all over the audience this morning, everyone that wants to go to heaven. Sure you do. You want to go to heaven. How many want to be ready when the Lord comes? How many of you don't care? How many of you are not ready, but you want to be? Friend, shall we pray? Our most
Brother Caves expressed his desires to go back to heaven 4 different times in this testimony. God called him home on Sunday morning, February the 12th, 1972, with a sudden heart attack. Though in good health, he had arranged his funeral service. God added 7 months to his life after his visit to heaven. But he left us with this beautiful testimony, and also completed and dedicated the beautiful church, which now stands as a memorial to his life.